Let me spend 1 hour with you, my sweetheart, so I may reveal my love to you. Oh, what a night for sweetheart, stars in the sky above. This is our chance for sweet romance. Let's make this a night of love.
G'day, Tragic here, and welcome to turn 9 of Arkham Horror. And, well, there was a mistake last game. Basically, I forgot to draw a monster for the gate that just opened. Oh, gee. Bam! Dark One. Oh, stationary monster. It's got physical resistant, nightmarish 1 and 3 health. So, not cool. So there's one monster. Okay, so let's just pick up the trophy thing. Now we're in a bit of a pickle, as Scott pointed out. Most of our characters only have 1 health left, which is bad. I'm not too worried because we are playing with the injury system, which we'll probably see actually go off. And remember, we do have an elixir of life on Mandy, so she can go to 0 health without worrying herself. She is going to use one of her focus to move down to 1 speed, and she's going to, I think, move her will up, give her 1 extra fight die. Meanwhile, good old Bob here, he is going to move his 1 to give him 4 speed. You know, he's actually going to stay at 3. And I think we're just going to leave everything else the same. Wilson, we're going to leave the way he is. And Ashcan is also going to stay where he is. Okay, so starting with Mandy, she's going to go 1. And suck up 2 clues at the graveyard. Give her much cluage. Right, so we have an interesting situation here. Basically, she is now at the graveyard, which is the second location for her mission. And she has to sacrifice 2 stamina at every location. But she's only got 1 stamina left. Now, basically, you can't go into negative stamina. And I'm going to say that she can just sacrifice that and kill herself. And complete this quest. Bonk. And then she's going to sacrifice the elixir of life, which says discard elixir of life instead of drawing an injury or madness card. Now these are the injury or madness cards, which are very, very handy in Dunwich, because the Dunwich horror, if he ever gets out, is so hardcore. But basically they return you to full health, right? So anyway, so now she then gets zapped to Arkham Hospital. And she's restored to full health. Now, I hear what people are saying. Yes, this says you have to sacrifice 2 stamina, and she only had 2 stamina. But every other instance in the game, you know, if you take damage, you can take damage over your limits. It just means you're dead. So I don't see that there's anything wrong with that. She went in. She did the ritual, you know, she cut her wrists over the bowl and chanted everything, but it actually killed her, you know? And so I call that done. Now it's Bob's turn, and he's going to use his 3 movement to go 1, 2, 3 to the unnameable. And with any luck, that's a very high frequency location, so if we're lucky, he might get sucked through. And Wilson just goes yunk. Now Ashcan Pete is going to try to get into the church. So he's going to go 1, 2 into the church. And he's got a sneak by this guy, though, which is a sneak minus 3. Now, his sneak is at 6, so he gets 3 dice. Boom! He gets past. So he gets past that pretty easily. And that takes him to the church. So now it is the various... actually, she's not at Arkham Asylum. She went to the hospital. Where's the hospital? It's all the way down here. Okay. Now, she's already at full health, so there's no point in doing anything at the hospital. So she's going to have an encounter there, which is the uptown streets. You're boing. St. Mary's Hospital. You agree to undergo an experimental treatment. Roll a die. On a 1 to 3, gain that many stamina. On a 4 to 6, nothing happens. Well, she's already at full stamina. 3, 4, 5, so who cares? We'll just do the roll. So she gets 2 stamina, but she can't go over a maximum stamina, so... useless. Complete waste of time. Now it is Jenkins' turn. And Jenkins is over at the unnameable. Let's check that, the unnameable. Make sure we get the right one. Pass a luck minus 1 check to find a hidden case concealed in the wall of an upstairs bedroom. Draw one unique item. He actually has a pretty good luck at 3, so he gets 2 dice. So, 2 dice. Boom, he gets it! So another unique item. Yoink! Ooh, the powder, plus 9 to magical combat checks. Ooh. Lose 1 sanity for using it though. Nice. Oh, that's going to come in very handy. Now, Ashcan Pete's going to do something a little interesting. He's at a church, and he's going to hand in his gate trophy to bless any investigator on the board. So he's going to chuck in his gate trophy, and he's going to bless Wilson here. Bam, look at that. Ooh. And finally, we have him at the line. Look. It doesn't, in the camera it actually looks very blue, but I swear that looks purple. It's the same color as that to my brain. But it's blue and yellow. So, want a blue or a yellow? Here's a yellow. Time and space bend around you. Make a luck minus 1 check. If you pass, return to Arkham. If you fail, stay here next turn. Ooh, a luck minus 1 check. His luck is at 1, 2, 3. So he's got a luck of 3 minus 1, so that gives him 2 dice. Now we want to pass this, so let's go. 2 dice. Yeah, bam! Oh, God, I got it. That worked too. Come on. Come on! Bam! Oh, miss. We're now going to use Mandy's ability to re-roll that. Yep, doesn't say Wild in Arkham, so can do it anyone. Yeah, boing! Booyah! Go Mandy, you're a beast. So he returns to Arkham, bang. And he goes here, and he gets an exploration token. Okay, so that was a decent event, I guess you'd call it. It's now time to pull the Thingo card, the Mythos card. Ah, okay, so we have a Monster Surge because Independence Square already is taken. By this, oh, that's Hidge Roadhouse. Oh, Independence Square! Damn it! Oh, if we can get some gates closed ASAP, we might have a chance, but it's not looking good. And we get Elder Thing. Yeah, boing! And now an Elder Thing. And of course, the ever omnipresent Doom token. Bang. Wow. I should have taken that item that reduced his... We're definitely going to have to fight this guy. We might have 3 turns if we're lucky. Right, so that's the end of... Oh, wait, more stuff. What else have I got to do? All right, now we have a big movement. So we've got Octagon's move, triangles, stars, and oblongs. It's a diamond... Octagon, he's a stationary monster. Diamonds. So no one moves. Finally, a strange power flux plagues the city. All investigators in Otherworld areas may immediately return to Arkham. Well, damn it, no one's in Otherworld areas. God, that would have been awesome. Okay, and a clue appears at the unnameable, and the clue goes to him at the unnameable. Yoink! Bang. Okay, gets discarded. And now we have to roll. You know, I forgot to roll with the blessed dice as well. Oh well. Oh no, it's a one! Oh. On a one or two, increase the terror level. Bam! Okay, so the terror level is now at three. Boom! The general store is now closed for business. Now you can still go to the location and have encounters, you just can't go to the store. We lose another ally. Who will it be? Plus one focus. Hmm. That's an awesome, awesome ally. And you get a skill. Wow. Dunk. So she runs away. Bit scary around here. But the Wheatley prophecy is also triggered, so boom! Oh, now that is harsh. Another core point to the Dunwich track. So, bad news. Just as a reminder, whenever, because we're running with the Wheatley prophecy, every time we close a store, we get a new token on the track. And then the Dunwich Horror comes out, and this Dunwich Horror is bad news. For starters, every time he moves, there's a chance of a Doom token being placed. And look at this. Can I get that in focus? Wow. 5 successes to kill. That's crazy. Okay, so we're in a lot of trouble here. Yeah, guys, it's really bad. We only got 2 tokens left, 2 turns left to the Doom track. Mandy can reverse the Doom track, but she's got to get all the way up to the Curiosity Shop, which is up here. So that's a minimum of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 spaces. So it's going to take her 2 turns to get there. But she has the most clues, so she's also might be best Cecile Gates. Or it's just it's pretty harsh. Okay, well, let's get us out of here.
Let me spend 1 hour with you, my sweetheart, so I may reveal my love to you. Oh, what a night for sweetheart, stars in the sky above. This is our chance for sweet romance. Let's make this a night of love.